In this session, we will discuss about how to add a scroll bar to your screen or your activity. There are many scenarios where the content of screen or activity may be larger than the physical device. In such kind of cases, we should allow user to scroll through the content. For example, observe this given screen design. Here, if you observe carefully, below this button, there is a huge amount of content which is going beyond this screen size. In such kind of cases, programmer has added a scroll bar here. Remember, sometimes the content of your screen may go beyond your physical screen size vertically. That means vertically, after this content, there is much more content. In such kind of cases, programmer should use vertical scroll bar. Similarly, in some cases, the content of your screen may go beyond your physical screen size horizontally. In such kind of cases, programmer should add horizontal scroll bar. This horizontal scroll bar to support horizontal scrolling, either right side or left side. This vertical scroll is to support vertical scrolling, either top or to the bottom. We know that there are different types of views. Remember, some views will come with default scroll view or default scroll property. Programmer should not add any scroll bar. Here I will mention such kind of views which will come with a default scroll bar or default scroll property. In fact, all adapter views will come with a default scroll property, that is list view, spinner, gallery, view pager, so and so. For these views, you don't have to add scroll bar explicitly. But whereas coming to first category and second category, first category and second category, they will not come with a default scroll bar. In the first category, some of the views may come with a default scroll bar, which I will be explaining in the later sessions. But most of the first category, that is individual views, and the second category, that is layouts, they will not come with a default scroll bar. For example, linear layout, relative layout, frame layout, table layout, they will not come with a default scroll bar. In such kind of cases, programmer should explicitly add scroll view. Now in this session, I will explain you how to add a scroll view to the screen design. First, let me draw the class hierarchy for scroll views. As you know already, the parent for any visible component is view. We know that there are many child elements are there for views. For example, button, checkbox, text view, so and so. Apart from that, view has a child class called as view group. We know that view group has many child classes. One side we have layouts, that is linear layout, and we have frame layout, so and so. And on the other side we have adapter views, that is adapter view. Now this frame layout has two important child classes, that is two scroll views. First one is scroll view. Here scroll view means vertical scroll view, and the second child is horizontal scroll view. It is single word without any space. Here scroll view means it is vertical scroll view. So there is no class called as vertical scroll view. Scroll view itself will act as vertical scroll view. And if you want horizontal scroll, that is this type of scroll, you should use horizontal scroll view class. Now I will try to add an important property related to scroll views. Scroll views are two types, horizontal scroll view and vertical scroll view. Since the parent class for both scroll views is frame layout, we know that frame layout can be used as placeholder for only one element, which means when you are using a scroll view or horizontal scroll view, make sure that scroll view or horizontal scroll view has only one child element, because frame layout is used to hold only one element. Similarly, scroll view can hold only one child element. So whatever the content you want to scroll through, you have to put that entire content within that one child. So for example, if you want vertical scroll bar, you have to take root element as scroll view, and whatever the content that has to be scrolled through, put that content as one child. Remember that single child itself can be a layout which can have huge amount of data which can be scrolled through. So first important point is, since scroll view's parent is frame layout, make sure that your scroll view tag will contain only one child element within the scroll view. Second point is, whenever you are using vertical scroll view, that is plain scroll view, most of the times that child element will be vertical linear layout. I will explain you the reason. Since this scroll view will add a vertical scroll bar, it makes more sense to have vertical linear layout as the child of this scroll view, because vertical linear layout will display the content in the vertical fashion or in the vertical orientation, that is one below each other. Similarly, whenever you are using horizontal scroll view, it makes more sense to use horizontal linear layout as a child element. Horizontal scroll view adds horizontal scroll bar, so internally it makes more sense to have horizontal orientation data. It makes more sense to have horizontal oriented data. So with this basic understanding, let me show some examples how to use vertical scroll view and horizontal scroll view. Let me create a new studio project. I will name it as scroll bar project. Just click until finish. First, I will show you example for scroll view. If you feel that content is going beyond your physical screen size vertically, you have to make sure that the root element should be scroll view. Remember, most of the times we add the root element as linear layout or relative layout. You have to remove that root element. In place of that linear layout or relative layout, use scroll view. And within that scroll view, if your content is vertically scrollable, take the child as vertical linear layout, and then you can start adding all the content or all the elements to that vertical linear layout. Now you can observe here, the root element is relative layout. Now I will make it as scroll view. As you are typing, you can observe two scroll views came. One is vertical scroll view and other is horizontal scroll view. Now I'll show scroll view example. Now don't worry about this corrupted preview. It will come out correctly. I will remove text view. First, let me remove this text view, because within the scroll view, you can have only one element. So if you try to put multiple elements, it will throw error. Let me show you. First, I have taken one button, then I will take one more button within this scroll view. Now observe, when I open preview, it is showing error as scroll view can host only one direct child. But currently we are having two children, that is button 1 and button 2. If you want to hold multiple elements which should be vertically scrollable, you remove all these elements and keep all these elements in the vertical linear layout. So let me take linear layout as only the child. I will make width as match parent, height as match parent. Can you tell me what's the orientation of this linear layout? It is horizontal. Now let me make it as vertical linear layout. Now within this, I will start adding some elements, that is two buttons. This is button 1, then button 2. Now observe the preview. It will come out correctly. Now let me copy paste these buttons for multiple times so that the content will go beyond our physical screen size. I'm just copy pasting same buttons. Here if you observe in the preview, it is not really showing vertical scroll view. It is simply expanding the same screen. So it is not showing any vertical scroll view. In order to verify this correctly, I recommend you to run this application on different phones. One with a smaller screen size, one with a bigger screen size. So let me copy lot of buttons. Now I have added tens of buttons, which looks like this. Now what I will do? I will run this application on the Jenny Motion. Probably then Jenny Motion should display vertical scroll view. Remember, scroll views will not appear in the previews or in the Android Studio. Even if you open this design perspective also, it won't display scroll view. Now let me run this application on Jenny Motion. Now let me run the application. Select Jenny Motion and click OK. Now let us wait for the output on the Jenny Motion. Now building is almost done. Now you can observe the output. Here you can observe when I am scrolling, a vertical scroll bar is appearing on the right hand side. That is here. I hope you understood. Now same example I can convert into horizontal scroll view. Rather than taking it as scroll view, okay, let me explain with a different XML. I will go to resources, layout. I will create one more XML file, layout XML file. I will name it as horizontal scroll example. The root element should be horizontal scroll view. So there should not be any spelling mistakes. Horizontal scroll view, click finish. Now within this horizontal scroll view, as I told you already, you have to take horizontal linear layout preferably. I will take it as match parent, width and height also match parent. Now within this, let me try to add first a checkbox with width wrap content, height match parent and with some text, some engineering. Similarly, I will take one more checkbox with option degree. Then I will take some radio buttons, width wrap content, height match parent, and I will give some text as male. Similarly, I will take one more radio button with the text female, and then I will take one plain button, width wrap content, height match parent, and then text as submit. Let me show you the preview. So preview may look like this. Our preview looks like this. Now let us make height of each element as rather than match parent, wrap content. Or else you can say, I will make each element's height as rather than match parent, I will make it as wrap content so that it looks better. So which looks like this. Though it looks like this in the preview, but when you run the real application on the real phone, automatically horizontal scroll will come. Let me show you. Remember, that is again depending on the screen size. If you are running this application on the tablet, probably tablet can fit 5 elements. So in that case, it may not display horizontal scroll bar. If you are running same application on low end phone, for example, on 4 inch phone, in that case, it may display a horizontal scroll bar. Let us run this application. Before running the application, I will go to activity Java file. We are setting XML as activity main XML, which contains vertical scroll view. Now let me set this XML as the main XML for our activity. If you observe the output, it will be displaying previous XML. We have designed a separate XML. So in the activity Java file, we have to apply that latest XML to see the horizontal scroll output. Let me run one more time. So probably the Jenny Motion width is too much width, so it is not showing horizontal scroll bar. Even if I am scrolling here, it is not visible. So what I will do? I will add some more elements, or I will copy paste same elements. Control C, just for understanding purpose. I'll copy paste 4 times. Now currently we have 20 elements horizontally. Now definitely it should display horizontal scroll bar. Let us see that. Now let me scroll through it. You can observe. So it is now horizontally scrollable. Okay. I hope you understood. Sometimes your content may be vertically scrollable as well as horizontally scrollable. In such kind of cases, you can take root element as vertical scroll view, and within that vertical scroll view you can take horizontal scroll view as child. If you take like that, you will get both vertical scroll bar and horizontal scroll bar. I hope you understood this concept.